Hello students, in my last video I discussed series and parallel combinations of resistors, right? In this video I am going to explain how to solve different numerical problems based on series and parallel combination of resistors. Okay, I am taking one problem here. In this problem, the given data are, the current value is given as 4 ampere in this circuit, with the current which is flowing in this circuit is given as 4 ampere. Potential across resistance R1, R2 and R3 are given as 5 volt across R1, 2 volt across R2, 6 volt across R3, right? And from this circuit it is clear that these three resistors are connected in series. Okay, now what we have to find out, we have to find out section A, the battery voltage. What is this voltage, battery voltage, we have to find out. Second, total resistance, what will be the value of total resistance in this circuit, we have to find out. And as well as the individual resistance R1, R2 and R3, we have to find out, right? Very simple question, right? How to solve it? For the section A, as we know that according to my previous lecture, when the resistors are connected in series, the voltage is divided in different parts. Now from this circuit we can write as V is equal to the summation of V1 plus V2 plus V3, right? V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3, and in the problem the value of V1, V2 and V3 are given. So put the values here. The values are 5 plus 2 plus 6. The answer is 13 volt. So the battery potential or battery voltage will be 13 volt. This is the answer for the first section. Now the second section. Okay, we have to find the total resistance value. We have to find the total resistance value. Now for total resistance, let the total resistance be R equivalent. Okay, now I assume that the total resistance of this circuit is R equivalent. So I am making a single diagram like this. The total resistance means the combination of these three resistance, that I assume as R equivalent. Okay, now battery voltage we have to already find out, that is 13 volt. Current which is flowing in a circuit is given as 4 ampere. Now we have to find the total resistance. So easily we can find as R equivalent is equal to voltage upon current. Put the values here. The values is 13 upon 4.3.25 ohm. This is the total resistance. Now the case 3, third case. Value of resistance R1, R2 and R3, very easy. We know that in the series combination the value of current flowing is same. So the value of current in the resistance R1 is 4 ampere, same as 4 ampere in R2, same 4 ampere in R3. But the potentials, but the voltages are different. So for the value of R1, we can write V1 upon I, right? What is the value of V1 is given as? That is given as 5 upon 4, that is 1.25 ohm. For R2, V2 upon I2 or V2 upon I, that is 2 by 4, 0.5 ohm. And for R3, that is V3 upon I, 6 upon 4, which is equal to 1.25 5 ohm. Right? Now the resistance R1 is 1.25, R2 is 0.5 and R3 is 1.5 ohm. This is the solution for this given numerical. Again, conclude that for the battery voltage, we use the summation of all the given terminal voltages V1 plus V2 plus V3. For the equivalent resistance, the current is 4 ampere and battery voltage is 13. So equivalent resistance or total resistance is 3.25. I find the individual resistance by using the voltage upon current formula. Okay. Now, second problem. Again, the given circuit is series circuit, but the problem is some different. In this circuit, the total battery potential is given as well as total resistance of the circuit is also given, right? And we have to find the value of potential difference across the resistance R3. We have to find the value of V3 or potential difference across the resistance R3. Current in the circuit, how much current flow through the circuit, we have to find out here. As well as what is the value of resistance R2, we have to find out here. Very simple problem. Now for the point A, section A. Again, for the series circuit, we know that here the voltage V or battery voltage divided in three parts. So we write V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3 by the series circuit condition. The total potential is divided three different voltage V1 plus V2 plus V3. Now the value of V is given as 25, V1 is given as 10, V2 is given as 4, but V3 is unknown here. Right? Now we have to find the value of V3. So from this we can write V3 is equal to 25 minus 14 or 9 or 11 volt. V3 is 11 volt. Okay. Now first answer is V3 is 11 volt. For the second problem, current in the circuit, we know that total resistance is given as, how much the value of total resistance is given as? Yes, 100 ohm. And what is the total potential? That is 25 ohm. So we have the value of total resistance as well as total potential. So easily we can find the current by using the formula I is equal to V by R. Now put the values here. The V is 25, R is 100, 25 fours are 100, that is 1 by 4 or 0.25 ampere. The current which flowing in a circuit is 0.25 ampere, right? Now third point, section C, value of resistance R2, we have to find the this resistance value R2. Here the voltage is given and we know that in the series circuit the current value is same. So here the current is 0.25. If here the current is also 0.25. So the value of current is same and potential is given. So we apply the formula R2 is equal to V2 upon I, or we can write as 4 upon 0.25. 4 upon 0.25, that is 400 upon 25, 5 5s are 25, 5 8s are 40. The answer is 16 ohm. The answer is 16 ohm. So the answers are, for the value of V3, 11 volt. For the current in the circuit, 0.25 ampere. Value of resistance R2, 16 ohm. Okay. Now I think clear the case of series. Now I am taking some problems for the parallel combination. Now the third question, I am taking here the third question, which is in parallel combination of resistance. Okay. Here three resistors are connected in parallel with the supply voltage V, and current flowing by a supply is I. And that current is divided in three parts. I1 current flowing through the resistance R1, I2 current flowing through the resistance R2, I3 current flowing through the resistance R3, right? And we also know that in the parallel combinations, potential is same, but the current is divided. So here the current I is divided in three parts, I1, I2 and I3. Now, what parameters are given for this circuit? The given data are the value of R1 10 ohm, the value of R2 20 ohm, the value of R3 60 ohm, as well as current I2 value is also given as 3 ampere. The current value I2 is given as 3 ampere. Okay. Now, we have to determine what is the value of this supply voltage, as well as what is the value of total current I which is flowing in the given circuit. Okay. How to solve this problem? Now, as we know that the current I2 is given, right? As we know that current I2 is given, so the potential across resistance R2 will be, how much the potential across resistance R2? If I am writing, this is V2, so V2 is equal to I2 into R2. Okay, V2 is equal to I2 into R2. Put the values. The value of I2 is given as 3, R2 is given as 20, so this is 60 volt. Right? Now, here the voltage is 60 volts and the combination is parallel, so voltage is same in each and every component, so the voltage across the supply is also 60 volt. Right? So, here I am writing here the circuit is in parallel, so the potential of the battery is also 60 volt. So our answer is V is equal to 60 volt because the combination is parallel, right? Now, we have to find the current I in the second case. If we want to find the current I, so we apply, first of all, we have to find the equivalent resistance of parallel combination. Now, if we find the total resistance of this combination, we easily find I is equal to V upon total resistance. Now, for the second case, total resistance, we know the formula, 1 upon R equivalent is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Now, putting the values, we get 1 by 10 plus 1 by 20 plus 1 by 60. After taking LCM, this becomes 66 plus 3 plus 1, or 10 by 60 or 1 by 6. This is the value of 1 by R equivalent. So, here I am rubbing it. So, the value of R equivalent will be 6 ohm. R equivalent 6 ohm means total resistance value of this combination will be 6 ohm. Now, what is the value of current? I is equal to V upon R equivalent. Put the value of R equivalent and V here. V is 16, R equivalent is 6, the current value is 10 ampere. So the current value is 10 ampere, the value of I is 10 ampere, the value of supply is 60 volt. Okay, clear? Okay. Now, the fourth question. Again, I am taking a parallel combination here in which the resistance R1 is given as 5 ohm, resistance R3 is given as 20 ohm. Current flow through the circuit from the supply is 11 ampere given here, and current in our resistance R1 is given as 8 ampere. Now what we have to find out? We have to find the reading of ammeter. Very interesting question. Reading of ammeter, it means how much current flow through the ammeter. Ammeter is a device which measures the current value. So ammeter is connected in series with the resistance R3. So how much current flow through the resistor R3 is measured by this ammeter. So we have to find the reading of ammeter, and secondly we have to find the value of R2. Now first of all, to solving this question, we have to find the value of this V here. Now look here, the resistance R1 and current I1 is given here. So by this parameter here, R1 is given as 5 ohm and I1 current assumed as 8 ampere. So we have to find the value of V1 by using the formula V1 equal to I1 R1, or which is equal to 8 into 5, that is 40 volt. So here the potential will be, if I am saying V1, so V1 will be 40 ohm. So this is a parallel circuit, so voltage V also 40 volt. Now the voltage of battery is also 40 volt. Okay, clear? Now voltage of battery is 40 volt. Now we have to find the current. Now if voltage here is 40 volt, how much voltage is here? Again 40 volt, because the voltage in parallel combination will be same. So we know the value of voltage, we know the value of resistance. Easily we have to find the current. If I am saying here the current value is I3, let the current in resistor R3 will be I3. So what is the value of I3? I3 is equal to V upon R3, or we can write 40 upon 20, that is 2 ampere. So now what is the reading of ammeter? The ammeter reading is 2 ampere. Finally we can write as ammeter reading is 2 ampere. Ammeter reading is 2 ampere. Now second, what is the value of R2? For finding the value of R2, if we find here the voltage is again 40, if we find this current value I2, so easily we can find the value of R2. Now what we do, we know that I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3, right? What is I is given here? I is 11, I1 value is given as 8, I2 value unknown, I3 value 2 ampere. So what is the value of I2? That is 1 ampere. I2 value become 1 ampere. Now here I2 is given, V is given, easily we can find the value of R2. Okay, I am rubbing here. For R2, we write as R2 is equal to V upon I2. What is the value of V? 40. What is the value of I2? 1. The answer is 40 ohm. So easily we find two parameters. Reading of ammeter is 2 ampere and the value of R2 will be 40 ohm. Okay. Hope you understand these problems, the parallel and series combination circuits, how to solve the parallel and series combination. Now I am giving you some questions. Attempt these questions, solve these questions. Okay. Thank you.